I'm Max Brantley with the Arkansas Times. It's Tuesday, September 23rd. Let's play horse race journalism. Polling is out today. It's from Public Policy Polling, a very well-respected organization in North Carolina that is actually Democratic-leaning, so it adds a little bit of impetus to what I'm about to say. It's polled everything in Arkansas on the ballot this year, and the news is bad for Democrats. Republicans lead in every race, from Senate down to land commissioner. I think the interesting thing about the poll is what it seems to reveal about the shape of the electorate. Republicans aren't above 50% in any race. The margins are very close, 4 to 5 points in the Senate and governor race, for example. But the numbers are strikingly similar, low 40s for Republicans, mid to high 30s for Democrats. You get the feeling that this is something of a sense of the rigid Republican and Democratic vote in Arkansas. It used to be reversed. Democrats were favored. That's no longer true. The only exception is Mike Beebe's continued high rating. Poll shows that in a matchup, hypothetical, in 2016 against John Bozeman, the Republican U.S. Senator, he'd win by 10 points. Unfortunately, I'm not sure he's going to run. Maybe he'll get bored in retirement and decide to do it after all. In other political news today, one of the Republican candidates who has a small lead in the race for Attorney General, Leslie Rutledge, is the subject of an FOI request on her papers when she worked for the Department of Human Services in 2007. The Attorney General's office today said a few more emails of hers should be released. They're not exempt from disclosure as personnel evaluation records. We'll see those directly. I expect they won't show much. What the FOI review does show, and it was done by Annabelle Ember Tuck, a retired Supreme Court justice, so there'd be no political taint on it, is that there are some records in these files that do have a bearing on her job performance, in that we know that she was terminated with a note saying that she not be rehired, in that we know the coding shows that she was found to have been guilty in some manner of gross misconduct. It seems to me that she ought to voluntarily step forward and ask the Department of Human Services to release all relevant records about her record. If it's trumped up stuff, it ought to be clear that it is. If she's not suitable to work as a lawyer for children in need of help in the state of Arkansas, she shouldn't be our Attorney General. Let's let the sun shine in. I have today on the Arkansas blog full reports of another poll, and it's by the Arkansas Coalition Against the Death Penalty. And it's one of their periodic samplings of opinions on the death penalty in Arkansas. A big majority, 67%, still favor the death penalty in Arkansas. But when you start asking the question differently, if, for example, people would favor replacing the death penalty with life without any chance of parole, you find a majority might favor that solution. I think we'll talk about it in the legislature. It's hard to imagine a Republican legislature being in favor of a change in the death penalty. 86% of Republicans favor the death penalty, but we haven't had an execution in 9 years. We're not going to have one for several years to come. There are immense numbers of problems apart from the irreversible problem of killing an innocent person. At some time we need to have this discussion in Arkansas, maybe in 2015 we will. The Judicial Discipline and Disability Commission today confirmed what we had talked about here yesterday and I've written about, and that is that it will review a complaint that Senator Jason Raypert talked at some length with a member of the Arkansas Supreme Court, Cliff Hoofman, in a conversation that did, by Raypert's own admission, at least touch on the marriage equality case, the same-sex marriage ruling that is pending before the Arkansas Supreme Court. There's no telling what else Cliffman talked to the senator about. Judges aren't supposed to talk about pending cases. There's some suggestion Raypert may have talked to other judges, although he says he cannot recall. Tracy Steele, a former legislator who's been heading the Department of the Division of Youth Services at the Human Services Department, is leaving the job at the end of October. He's one of what will be a parade of Beebe administration people leaving. Tracy Steele mostly enjoyed positions in state government as patronage work. I suspect he can be replaced. Finally, we wrote on the Arkansas blog this morning about an interesting talk in Little Rock yesterday by Charlotte Jones Anderson. She's the daughter of Jerry Jones, owner of the Dallas Cowboys, and a very high-ranking executive in the organization herself. She addressed the need for the NFL to deal with problems of domestic violence and child abuse that have come up in some high-profile cases, and to better inform players and do a better job of having people understand how problems off the field can affect you on the field. Good point. She's a brilliant woman, graduate of Central High, graduate of Stanford University, makes a great face for the NFL as a career woman who really can speak well and knows what she's talking about. she didn't mention, and the local press was far too kind to bring up, that the Dallas Cowboys maybe in getting houses in order have some house cleaning to do at home. There have been some high-profile tabloid incidents involving executives at the highest reaches of the Dallas Cowboys, not to mention, of course, the famous Dallas Cowboy cheerleaders, who some spoil sports say might objectify women to a certain degree. It's an interesting discussion. Opinions have been raging hot and heavy on our social media pages about this, so I invite you to take a look. I'm Max Brantley. I'll be back tomorrow.